Hello dear students, I hope you are safe, I hope you are good, I hope your family members are good, okay. As you know, we are doing chapter number 9, Ray Optics of class 12th. Till now we have done 7 parts, today it is going to be the 8th part. In the last video lecture, we have discussed about refraction through spherical surfaces. Today, the same topic will continue and then after we'll solve some numericals on the basis of the formula, what we learned. Yesterday I have proved it for concave surface when the object is in rear medium and the image is formed in rear medium only, means the refraction was taking place from rear medium to denser medium. Today I am going to do it for convex surface, and let us take the refraction this time from denser medium to rear medium, and then if required I'll be doing one more for convex surface, rear to denser. Okay, so let us do refraction through a convex surface. Refraction through a convex surface, a convex surface, and now we are going to do from denser to rear medium. Okay, I'm going to do for denser to rear medium. How the surface will be look like? The surface will be something like this. This is convex surface, right? And let this be its principal axis. Okay. Let this be its center of curvature somewhere. Okay. Let here be its center of curvature C. Now, if the refraction takes place from denser medium to rear medium, the object must be somewhere here. Say this is your object. So from the object what happens? A ray of light goes straight along the principal axis, and it goes along the principal axis only. It does not get, it does not undergo refraction because it falls on the surface normally, since it is along from the center of curvature to the surface. So basically it falls on the surface normally, and that is why it does not undergo refraction. Now Let me make the surface a bit big. Let this be the surface. So that understanding will be clear. Now, from the object another ray on the surface. Now what happens? The ray of light is going from denser medium to rear medium. So ray of light must bend away from the normal. For that, normal will be drawn from the center of curvature. So this particular line on the point of incidence, it works as normal. So ray of light should go this way. Okay, means original path of ray of light this. Now it will be bending downward so that it will bend away from the normal. If it goes upward, so it will be towards the normal, because here it normal. Here is the normal, this is the normal, and original path of ray is this one. So if the ray of light is bending upward, so basically it will be bending towards the normal. So ray of light bend downward. So what happens, where the ray of light will go? Somewhere here. So somewhere here I am going to get the image, which is I. Okay. If I want to define angle of incidence, so this is normal, this is incident ray. So this is your angle of incidence. This is normal, this is refracted ray. So this is angle of refraction. Okay, for object we have already considered it is alpha, for image beta, for center of curvature one gamma, for normal. And let this point be P, pole. Okay, let us define the distances here. The distances will be like PO, it will be the object distance, it will be minus U. PI, it will be the image distance, it will be plus V, because image is made that side. PC, it is radius of curvature, and it is minus R because it is moving in this direction. The refractive index of denser medium, let it be mu 2, and the refractive index of rear medium, let it be mu 1. Okay, refractive index of denser medium is mu 2 and the refractive index of rear medium is mu 1. Now again I am going to do with the same procedure as I have done in the last one. First of all, let us apply Snell's law. From Snell's law, mu 2 sin I must be equal to mu 1 sin r, and if I and r are very small, so basically sin I is approximately equal to I and sin r is approximately equal to r. So from here what we can do, we can write mu 2 I is equal to mu 1 r. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the values of I and r from the figure. Now just see I in this triangle, O, let this point be A, OAC, I is here, gamma is exterior angle, alpha and I, they are interior angles. So basically gamma will be equal to alpha plus I, gamma will be equal to alpha plus I. So I will be equal to gamma minus alpha. So in here, in place of I, we can put gamma minus alpha. Okay, is equal to mu 1 r. What is the value of r here? R is here. So r is the exterior angle of the triangle CAI. CAI. For this triangle, r is the exterior angle. So r is going to be equal to gamma plus beta. So r is going to be gamma plus beta. I hope you know this thing. Then for a triangle, if this is the exterior angle and these two are interior angles, so angle 3 is equal to angle 1 plus angle 2. This happens in triangle. The same is happening over here. R is exterior angle, gamma and beta are interior angles. So in place of gamma, we can put gamma, in place of R, we can put gamma plus beta. Same I have used here also. So now gamma and gamma terms together. So let this mu 2 goes that side and let this beta come this side. Or let this gamma comes over here and let this alpha goes that side. So if that gamma comes over here, we'll get mu 2 minus mu 1 into gamma is equal to mu 1 beta plus, since alpha goes that side, so from negative it will become plus mu 2 alpha. Okay, now I'm going to put the values of alpha, gamma, beta and alpha, means alpha, beta and gamma from the triangle. Again, the rays are paraxial, so that's why, since rays are paraxial and therefore alpha, beta and gamma are very small. Okay, so for alpha, beta, gamma, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put alpha as arc upon radius, beta as arc upon radius and gamma as arc upon radius. Okay, so here I'm going to have mu 2 minus mu 1. For gamma, PA will work as an arc and PC will work as a radius. So it will be PA upon PC is equal to mu 1 beta. For beta, PA will be acting as arc and PI will be as radius. So PA upon PI plus mu 2 alpha. So for alpha, PA will act as an arc and PO will act as a radius. So PA arc and PO radius. PA, PA and PA are there everywhere. So it will be cancelled out and we'll have mu 2 minus mu 1 upon PC is equal to mu 1 upon PI plus mu 2 upon PO. Now let us put the value. Mu 2 minus mu 1 upon PC. So PC is radius of curvature, it is minus R, is equal to mu 1 upon PI is V, it is plus, so V. Mu 2 upon PO is minus U. So this minus will become this minus will make this plus minus, and this minus, because of this minus here the things are inverted, so it will be like mu 1 minus mu 2 upon R is equal to mu 1 upon V plus mu 2 upon U. This is the formula I was looking for. It is same as the last formula we have derived in the last video lecture. Only the thing is mu 1 and mu 2 are exchanged. I have told you also that here the in that case the refraction was taking place from rarer medium to denser medium. So formula was like, let me write, from formula was like mu 2 upon V minus mu 1 upon U is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 upon R. It was for rare medium to denser medium, and now we have derived it for denser medium to rarer medium. Let me write it in correct way. Correct way means only the sides will be changed. So mu 1 upon V minus mu 2 upon U this side, and mu 1 minus mu 2 upon R this side. So just see what is the difference between this formula and this formula. Only the mu 1 and mu 2 get exchanged. So instead of learning it like mu 1 and mu 2, you just learn it like refractive index of second medium upon image distance minus refractive index of first medium upon object distance is equal to refractive index of second minus refractive index of first upon radius of curvature. It will go with this one also and this one also. It will be fit with this one also and this one also. Okay, you don't need to learn. First of all, take the screenshot and you have to note it down. So pause the screen and note it down. Otherwise, take the screenshot and do it afterwards. Okay, I'm giving you time for 1 minute. Okay, now I'm going to remove some things from here. So don't learn it like mu 2 and mu 1 and so on. Okay, learn it like refractive index, or let it be like mu. Mu represents refractive index. So mu of second medium upon image distance minus mu of first medium upon object distance is equal to mu of second minus mu of first upon the radius of curvature. Learn this formula. Instead of learning mu 2 and mu 1, learn this one. It will fit with both. Okay, it will fit with both, with rare to denser also and denser to rarer also. It will fit with both. How? Let us see. What I do, I have told in the classes also. Okay, in the beginning when the classes were running, I have told that I used to take mu 1 as always rare and mu 2 as always denser. Okay, I have made a kind of personal rule. Okay, so it is not necessary that always the rare is mu 1 and denser is mu 2. Okay, just to make the understanding clear, I have made like this. Okay, now just see, if the ray of light is going from mu 2, which is denser, to mu 1, which is rarer. So if the ray of light is going from denser to rarer, so denser is going to be first medium and rarer is going to be second medium. So what you need to do, you need to write the formula like mu 2, ray of light is mu of second is this one, so it will be like mu 1 upon image distance, that is a V, minus mu of first will be this one, so mu 2 upon U is equal to whatever it is, mu second minus mu first, so mu 1 minus mu 2 upon radius of curvature. You need to put this formula. And if it is happening from rare to denser, then, so in this case, mu 1 is going to be the first medium. It is going to be the first, and mu 2 is going to be what? Second. So in that case, the formula will be like refractive index of second medium, which is mu 2, upon image distance V, refractive index of first medium, which is mu 1, upon object distance, that is U, is equal to refractive index of second minus refractive index of first upon radius of curvature. We need to put this formula. So instead of learning it like mu 2, mu 1 and all, just learn it like this. mu of second medium upon image distance, mu of first medium upon object distance, mu of second minus mu of first upon radius of curvature. And please remember, whenever we solve numericals, we have to put these variables with sign conventions. And for sign convention, there is a simple rule. The direction of incidence light is considered to be positive. Okay, this is a simple rule, and the opposite direction to it will be considered as negative. Simple. Okay, so let us solve some numerical so that we can understand whether we have understood the formula or not. Now the question is, let me give you the question symbolically. If a sphere is there, glass sphere of radius 10 centimeter, okay, let there be a mark on the surface, capital M. Okay, capital M is a mark. What you need to do? You need to find apparent position of capital M when it is viewed from diametric opposite point. Means, if we view it from here, capital M it from here, what will be its apparent position? This is the question. Okay, let us do. First of all, ray diagram. From M, a ray of light goes along the principal axis. Say this is your center of curvature. And another ray falls on the surface. So now the ray of light is going, since it is glass, and for glass refractive index is taken as 1.5. If nothing is given outside, so we can consider it as air. So ray of light is going from denser medium to rarer medium, and ray of light have to be bent away from the normal. Okay, so let us see where the normal is. This is the normal, and what we need to see, we need to see that ray of light should bend away from the normal. So just see, ray of light original path is this one. It should bend away from the normal, so it will bend downwards. So whether it will bend downward like this or it will bend downwards like this, we'll be finding it afterwards. Because if it bends like this, the image will be somewhere here, okay, and if it bends like this, we need to extend it behind, so image will be somewhere behind. Okay, so after finding the value of V, we'll decide that how much it will bend. Okay, how much it will bend, it will be decided afterwards. Okay, so let us try to solve. So what is the formula? Formula is refractive index of second medium. Let me write the formula first of all. Refractive index of second upon image distance minus refractive index of first upon object distance is equal to refractive index of second minus refractive index of first upon radius of curvature capital R. This is the formula. Okay. So let us try to put the values over here. The refractive index of second medium. Now the ray of light is going from glass to air. So glass will be our first medium, air will be our second medium. And for air, refractive index is 1. Refractive second, air is our second, glass is our first. So refractive index of second medium means refractive index of air, it is 1 upon V, we don't know, minus refractive index of first, it will be 1.5 upon object distance. What will be the object distance? Object distance is always measured from pole. For this surface, this is a pole, and for pole to object distance, it is PM, and since radius is 10, so object distance will be minus 20. Why I'm taking it negative? Because we are moving this side and ray of light traveling this side. So we are moving opposite to the incident light. That's why it is negative. Is equal to refractive index of second medium, which is 1, minus refractive index of first medium, which is 1.5, upon radius of curvature. PC again we are moving that side, so it will be minus 10. Now we need to solve this one only. So what we are going to have, 1 upon V plus it will be 1.5 upon 20 is equal to, it will be minus 0.5 in the numerator, minus 10 in the denominator, So ultimately it will be 0.5/10. Now this will be transferred that side. We'll have 0.5/10 minus 1.5/20. If we take LCM, it will be 20. So it will be 0.5 × 1, 1.0 minus it will be 1.5. 1 minus 1.5, how much? We are going to have 0.5/20. It is 1/V. So basically, V is going to be 20/0.5, and it will be what? 40 cm. So on one more thing. Whether I have missed negative sign? Yes, I have missed. 1 minus 0.5, it will be negative. So final answer will be minus 40 cm. It simply means that the distance is somewhere this side only. So ray of light will bend in such a manner that when we extend it behind the, you can say behind, we'll get somewhere apparent position of the image. Okay, this will be also extended behind. Somewhere here it will cut and we'll get the apparent position of capital M. Because it is negative, if it would have been positive, I'll be bending the ray of light in such a manner so that it will cut this side. But it comes out to be negative, so basically it simply means that the image is behind only, and for that, ray of light is bent not that much, it will bent a bit, and when we extend it behind, we'll get the image at I. Okay, I hope this question is clear. Okay, just pause the screen and note it down. Now let me move to the second question. Okay, let me remove it. Now let us try to solve second question. In the second question also one sphere is there, a glass sphere. Okay, a glass sphere is given, and the radius of this glass sphere is given as, already we have studied, 10 cm. Okay, so this is the glass sphere and its radius is given as 10 cm. R is given as 10 cm. Okay, let this be its axis. Now question is, there is a bubble somewhere here, let it be here, somewhere here. Okay, this is center, this is bubble, and it is given that bubble, air bubble, is at 4 cm from the center. Find its apparent position when it is viewed from first nearest end, second farthest end. Let there be two question. Okay, when it is viewed from nearest end, means it is viewed from this side, nearest to the bubble, and when it is farthest point, when it is viewed from here. Okay, again, if it is viewed from here, so ray of light must start from the bubble and reach to our eye. Okay, ray of light must start from the bubble and reach to our eye. So let us try to solve it and let us try to find out where its apparent image will be. Okay, where its apparent image will be, let there here be the bubble B. Okay, now just try to understand. For the first ray will go like this along the principal axis only. Okay, let this be the pole, and another ray will go like this. Now what happens? This time the ray of light is going from denser medium to rare medium. Its refractive index is given, it is 1.5. So now what happens? Ray of light must bend away from the normal. So this is the normal. Okay, let this be the normal. The original path of the ray is this one. This is the original path. And ray of light have to bend away from the normal. So ray of light will go something like this. So ray of light will bend like this. So when it is extended behind, we'll find somewhere here the apparent position of bubble, which is image of the B. Is it clear? So I am going to find out the distance of I from the P. Okay, this is the task. One is refracted light somewhere here, one is refracted light here. So it is extended behind to get the position of I. Okay, now again let me write the formula. So mu of second upon image distance minus mu of first upon object distance is equal to mu of second minus mu of first upon radius of curvature. So again from the P I am going to solve. So mu of second, again the ray of light is going from glass to air, so air will be our second medium, glass will be our first medium. So mu of second will be air, so it will be 1 upon V minus mu of first, it is 1.5 upon U. So U is going to be PB. Now radius is given as 10 centimeters, so basically from P to C it is 10, from C to B it is given 4. So what will be the distance from P to B? It will be 6, and that too with negative. Why is it so? Because we are moving this side. I hope you are able to understand why it is 6. From P to C it is 10, from C to B it is 4, so P to B is equal to 6. It should be negative because we are moving this side. Is equal to mu of second, it is 1, minus mu of first, it is 1.5 upon radius of curvature. Radius of curvature, we are moving this side, so PC will be minus 10 centimeter. Again, we have to solve it. So 1 V is equal to plus 1.5 upon 6 is equal to 0.5 upon 10. It will be transferred that side. So 1 upon V is equal to 0.5 upon 10 minus 1.5 upon 6. The LCM of 10 and 6 is 30. 10 threes are 0.5, 3s are 1.5, 6 5s are 1.5, 5s are 7.5. So 1.5 minus 7.5, it will be 5.0. 5.0. Okay. 1.5 minus 7.5, it will be 6, not 5. It will be minus 6.0 upon 30. Okay. Minus 6.0 upon 30. It is the value of 1 upon V. So 6 will cut this 35 times. So V comes out to be what? Minus 5 centimeter. So basically from P to I, it is 5 centimeter. Okay, PI is 5 centimeter. From the pole, it appears to be at 5 centimeter. From the center, again, it will be 5 centimeter because P to C, it is 10. Okay, so this is the solution of the first part when it is viewed from nearest end. Now if it is viewed from farthest end, so ray of light I have to change, I have to convert the ray diagram. So please pause the screen and note it down so that we can solve the second part. Okay, now I'm going to solve second part. Ray diagram I have to change, that's why I'm removing all this. Okay, let this be the glass sphere now. Here is the center of curvature. Here is the bubble. And now it is viewed from this side. So if it is viewed from this side, the ray of light must travel from bubble to the eye. So one ray of light is passing along the axis. And it will go along the axis only. So one ray of light goes along this axis and it will go like this only. Another ray will fall on the surface. Now it will going from denser medium to rarer medium. So basically it will bend away from the normal. So this is our normal here. Now the ray of light will bend away from the normal. So ray of light will go like this. So if I extend it behind, I'll be finding somewhere image this side. Okay, this is the same question as we have done the last question. Again, refractive, and directly now I'm going to apply the formula. Refractive index of second medium, it is air, so 1 upon image distance minus refractive index of first medium. First medium is glass itself, so it will be 1.5 upon object distance. Now from this side I need to know object distance, because this is the refracting surface. So from P to C it is 10, from C to B it is 4. So the refractive, the object distance is going to be 14. And one more thing, we are going this side, so distance should be positive. But remember the rule. The rule is not like this side is positive and this side is negative. The rule is the direction of incident light is considered to be positive. And this time the direction of incident light is this way. So basically this direction is positive and this direction is negative. I have to put minus 14. Okay? Direction of incident light is this way. So this direction is positive. This direction is negative and this direction is positive. Is equal to second minus first upon radius of curvature. I'm going this side, so it will be minus 10. So again, if I solve it, it will become 1 upon V plus 1.5 upon 14 is equal to 0.5 upon 10. If it is transferred to that side, it will be 1 by V is equal to 0.5 upon 10 minus 1.5 upon 14. If I take the LCM, it will be 70. So 7 times this, it will be 3.5 minus 14, 5s are 5, 15, 5s are 7.5. So 3.5 minus 7.5, it will be 4. So minus 4.0 upon 70. So V will be equal to what? 70 upon 4. If we cut it, we'll be having 17 upon 0.5 centimeter. Okay. 35 half, 17.5. Okay. So from P it is 17.5. So it will not bend that much as I have shown in the ray diagram. It will not bend that much that the ray of light should go away out of the sphere. Like suppose if this is the original path of the ray, so ray of light will bend a bit only, so that if we extend it somewhere here, the image is formed. Okay, behind the bubble. From the pole it is 17.5, from the center it will be 7.5. Okay, from this side it will be 2.5. Okay, so this is how we solve these questions. One or two more questions can be solved, but I am leaving up to you. Just try to solve the questions given in the book. Okay, we'll solve one more, two more questions in the next video lecture, and then after I'll move to lens maker's formula. Okay, then after the lenses will start. Okay, so this is all for the day. Just keep yourself safe. Okay, and keep on studying hard. The positive aspect of this one is you are getting time to study. Okay, take care of your health first of all, and then after, if you are healthy, if you are getting all the things at time, so please try to concentrate on study. Okay, study hard and try to utilize this time. Okay, so this is all for the day. Thank you.